Pótale el pinche chero, lo van a la mano donde va a llegar.
Es que tengo que
si el canal mejor lo va a chingar.
They definitely should let him sit down in that corner so at least he gets a minute rest in between rounds. But Canelo Alvarez doing everything he can do to win a fight. Jabs, hooks, combinations. Look at that. 3-4 shots to the body. I mean, he's doing it all. 9-0, Canelo Alvarez.
Boy, don't you suspect it's the fighter's choice to stand up between rounds?
That's exactly who it is. I think it's all Canelo Alvarez proving two points. That he's in shape, that he's ready for Triple G, and that he's definitely going to beat Chavez here tonight. So he's trying to give up all type of messages because he knows Triple G is sitting at ringside. So he's letting everybody know that he's in the best shape of his life, and he's ready for whatever.
You know, sparring in training camp, Roy, yeah, he's very relaxed. It's easy work. When you're sparring in training camp, do you stand up between rounds?
Yes, you do. They don't put a stool in the ring, it takes up too much time.
I think he's showing Chavez that this is a sparring session for him.
Could be.
Oh, what an uppercut.
Hit him?
I don't care how bad the opposition is, the precision with which Canelo does what he does is enormously impressive.
This Canelo Alvarez would give anybody on the planet a real problem.
Well, anybody on the planet is seated right over there on the far side. And his name is Gennady Gennadyevich Golovkin.
And given Golovkin's struggles in his last fight and how Canelo looks in this fight, if that fight can be made this year, Canelo's fortunes, his prospects of winning will be considered by many to be much greater than they would have been, you know, 6 months or a year ago.
100% correct. So much of the timing of the fight is going to turn out to be exactly right.
If in fact it takes place. So much of boxing is perception and match making. Triple G was just a really good fighter. Although he's been a professional for Danny James, strong, fast, everything. And here Canelo's in with a guy who really didn't show up to try.
Este programa me anda cachando.
También.
Uh-huh. El último round era el 11 round, lo voy a chingar.
¿Cómo te vas a hacer el
11? ¿Cómo te vas a hacer el 11? Yo te voy a entrar con todo. El pinche que tiene que pasar en
un
ese no pelea ningún presión. No, pero que
as Gennady turns to the camera and gives us a smile. Through 10 rounds, Chavez is landing 6 of 26 per round. Again, in his previous 8 fights, he was averaging 16 out of 40. That was against a different level of opposition. This is Canelo Alvarez.
Not often we see the short guy come out and out jab the tall guy. Tonight, the short guy's jab dominated the fight.
When I say Chavez hasn't shown up to win, he may have had some kind of superficial game plan, but look what's happening. Is he thinking he's going to faint himself into position and maybe counter something from Canelo and start to pile up points? That's not ever going to happen. His only chance is to go for broke, and he's unwilling to do it.
With his experience, though, Max, I feel like he came in with a trainer who he thought had a perfect plan. Once he got in there and realized that the trainer's plan didn't work, he doesn't know anything else to turn to.
How in the world could they have come up with that plan?
Y'all want to know that.
20,510 spectators here. Some of them now booing. And no doubt they are booing Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. for what they will see as a less than exemplary effort from a Mexican star fighter.
At this point, his only, he could take pride in going to making the weight and going the distance.
That was a good body shot by Canelo.
Canelo long ago turned the fight into a rout. Only question in recent rounds has been, can Canelo pile up enough punishment? And Kenny Bayless would elect to stop the fight, or that the corner would say, hey, look, there's really no point. But of course, this is Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. These are the two great Mexican fighters. He's almost honor bound to finish the fight.
These are the one great Mexican fighter.
Exactly. And now the crowd chants Canelo. Canelo. At this moment, there may be some who came here as Chavez fans who are chanting Canelo, Canelo.
And now the boos begin again. But Chavez fans, you know, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me 15 times, shame on me.
A buggy whip right to the body. Brutal punishment. Okay. Closing seconds of round number 11. Issue utterly beyond doubt. One round to go.
Number round, can I boss?
Uno.
Last round, Julio.
Let's feel.
You beat him 11 rounds. You gotta win this one and that's it. Don't get crazy. Careful. You have to hit you on the fight. Don't look forward. Attack him, push him back, flex your weight, and you're doing good. Good jab. A lot of damn jab, and move that weight. Flex that weight. One round, jump. Okay.
Cuando cae lo chinga, no cae, vámonos. Cuando roja en uno, dos. ¿Uno?
Never once during this fight did Canelo Alvarez sit down on a stool between rounds.
Yeah.
He made a visible display
of standing for every
between-round period.
Is that your head, man? That's your...
Yeah.
Mira,
otro.
Has not landed as many as 10 punches in any round in the fight so far. As to how many punches he wanted to land. Fighting at his usual measured pace, fighting with his usual immaculate precision, utterly dominating his opponent.
He made Chavez keep his hands at home for defense.
In boxing, skills pay the bills. Craft is king. And those people who understood this fight from the beginning and were serious about it have been on the same train all the way.
There's no way Chavez can beat Canelo given the difference in the level of skill.
And you get out what you put in. You know, Andre Ward, Vasily Lomachenko, Gennady Golovkin, Canelo Alvarez. You talk about the top of the sport. These guys are all extremely serious competitive athletes who respect themselves and respect the sport and give themselves the best chance to be great. And that is not what Chavez Jr. has done.
With no nonsense between fights, no headlines for things that take place outside the ring. That generally is what defines the top guys who Max Kellerman just named.
Kovalev, Chocolatito.
Chavez Jr. has been exactly the opposite. So at the end of the day, after years of discussion about these two big Mexican names, after the final fulfillment, what some thought would never happen, getting them into the ring together, it became an exhibition. An exhibition of all the skills that Canelo Alvarez has took and Alvarez and Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. has never had.
And in retrospect, it was always going to be an exhibition.
But you couldn't tell that to the nation of Mexico, which craved it, got it, and now can talk about it for 48 hours before the Canelo fans go on and celebrate forever.
Diego, cara, Junior no hizo nada, no. Nada.
Somewhat reminiscent of the second fight between Oscar De La Hoya and Julio Cesar Chavez Sr. When De La Hoya was able to dominate and embarrass Chavez Sr., finally won over a certain percentage of Mexican fans who had resisted Oscar all those years. Not that many Mexican fans who resist Canelo, but those who have been ardently forever in the emotional Chavez camp have to now admit reality about what the difference was between the two.
Yes, they do. And they won't have to see this again because he's totally dominated it and shut it down.
The notion of a rematch would be absurd. And the two fighters with a word for each other. Well, the final scores have a ring of authenticity and sameness. Let's go to Michael Buffer for the official
ladies and gentlemen, all three judges have the same score, 120-108. All to the winner by unanimous decision. De Guadalajara, Jalisco, México, Saúl Canelo. Ah!